Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I don't know I will be able to use my PowerPoint or not, but I will try my best. Thank you very much for all our distinguished guests who visit us here in UTM, and we are very happy to share with you some our knowledge about the local history of Islam, and so on. So, of course, Sufism is one of the most significant aspects of the history of Islam in the Malay world. The contribution of Sufis in spiritual and intellectual life of the region is difficult to overestimate. Many spiritual leaders and intellectuals have been known here since very early time. Their names are inscripted in the Malay intellectual heritage. The works of Araniri, Hamzaf Ansuri, and many others devoted to thousands of pages of scientific works. And still many confusions and prejudices regarding the Tasawuf and Sufis in the Malay-Indonesian archipelago spread widely in the public opinion as well as among the specialists. Some Western scholars believe that Sufis in the Malay world are some kind of street magicians, similar to shamans and sorcerers from pre-Islamic time. Others believe that Sufism is a special sect in Islam, whose members consider themselves free from performance of traditional religious rules and duties. Nowadays, a negative view towards Sufism and denial of its all in Islam is associated with certain political factors. Therefore, it's so much important to investigate and explain the truth and essence of Sufism and its role in the intellectual development of Malay world. Next, please. The study of Malay Muslim historiography have been traditionally considered to be part of the Oriental studies, known as Malay studies, and this field of knowledge have its own history and its own specific strengths and weakness. On one hand, profound Western scholars have laid the foundation of the modern science of history based on the fundamental methods of studying the historical sources, and that is why Provaliatas emphasized that we have to acknowledge them, and their brilliant contribution evokes due praise. And next, please. And on the other hand, many Orientalists were prone to Eurocentrism, held a biased attitude toward the local population, and reflected negative perception toward Islam, and thus formed misjudgment of this impact of the local history and culture. And that is why Provaliatas continued that we must sincerely acknowledge and affirm what is true in the interpretation of our history, which they have gradually set and equitably agreed among themselves. One of the misunderstandings spread widely among the Orientalists is the wrong perception regarding the Tasawuf and Sufism in the Malay-Indonesian archipelago. According to Winstead, Sufism is no more than transformed magical practice of Hinduism. Former Hindus of seclusion for certain days of the week or for a period, the magician now claim an Arabic name, Halwat, an Islamic sanction. If he remains celibate or if he fasted just to impress his clients or to enable himself to see visions, he was no longer a Hindu ascetic, but he the disciple of the crude Sufism, also derived from India. Originally, to become a shaman, he had kept vigil beside an open grave or waited in the dark forest for the coming of the tiger familiar. He would now sit fasting and shrouded to hear the prayers for the dead read over him and would repeat the name of Allah 5,000 times until hysteria brought nightmare vision of tiger or serpent, to be succeeded by visions of agent and science instructing him in his mystic knowledge. That is how the Orientalists, especially in the beginning of 20th century, understand and the feeling about the local tradition of Tasawuf. The teaching of his shaman and Shaiva forerunners made it natural for the Malays to accept the Sufi doctrine that as a disciple must honor and obey his master and pass through several stages of the initiation. Muslim amulets and Sufi mysticism succeeded naturally to the talismans and ascetic practice of Hindu, and those talisman and practices to fetish and shamanism of primitive days. This kind of point of view is quite popular until now, even in scientific writing, so-called scientific writing. Winstead masterly described the system of so-called folk's magic, but he did not realize the crucial conceptual difference between the street magician and the Sufis. According to him, Islam did not change the native beliefs and spirits. Islam not only related the spirits and gods, according to him, of older faiths, but introduced the Malay to Iblis, an evil with whom his magic had never before had the chance of dealing. That is only what he see in the Islamization of the Malay-Indonesian archipelago. Winstead, in his notion of Sufis, next please, yeah? Next please. Okay. Winstead, in his notion of Sufis, focused on some technical aspects and some practical aspects of rituals, such as amulets, jumping, described their intercourse with ghosts and jinns, medical practices, primitive astrology, and other adat elements. There is no one reference to the Sufi philosophy and metaphysics, to the great local intellectuals and scholars, to the famous kitabs on Tasawuf and Islamic thought, as if all of this never existed in the Malay tradition of Islamic mysticism. He describes Sufis as some kind of low-class, uneducated disciples, as sociopaths with antisocial behavior, who could be comparable with the shamans or bomos of the pre-Islamic time. Their belief and the practices represent actually so-called folk religion, with its syncretic in its nature and not the real classical Islam. And in this case, Winstead probably was right to declare that this kind of religion and beliefs had been brought from India by Indian traders and vagabond magicians. Winstead's sentences above could be accepted as a suitable and quite exact description of the pagan system of tradition and belief, and that is precisely from what Islam liberated the humankind. Alatas wrote, Islamization is the liberation of man from the from magician, magical, mythological, animistic, national, cultural tradition opposed to Islam, and then from secular control over his reason and his language. The man of Islam is he whose reason and language are no longer controlled by magic, mythology, animism against to Islam and secularism. He is liberated from both their own national and cultural traditions, opposed magical and the secular worldviews. The issue with proper identification of the Sufis and their contribution to the Malay history, the next, please.